All right, let's get this show on the road. Hello and welcome to Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show now appearing daily. My name is Brendan. This is my show. We're continuing on this week with drafting. We're doing pretty well. Sitting at about 2,500 words, pretty close. Got another scene to write. I'm excited. Hey, Michele, what's up? No, you're misspelling that on purpose. I woke up with a song stuck in my head. Hilarious. Man, I listened to that interview. She's out. She's not home right now. She won't be here. But she did just break 200 followers and is having a 200 follower stream today. I want to make it. I hope I can make it. My internet's not great right now. My upload's great. my download is not so great. So, having some issues. But, you know. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, she was pretty happy about it. I wanted to watch, but my internet was not cooperating. I spent like 3 hours trying to fix my internet last night. I assume it was like Sam Peterson, Stevie, and somebody else. I would think, but I mean, maybe not. I have a thing.
Yeah, there.
I clean my glasses. I don't know who else was streaming though. Who was the third one, Michele? I don't know, I've never been in an art stream who didn't know who Dronny was, so... She also wrecks me as a streamer. It's really hardcore. I mean, I'm friends with Adobe people too. But yeah. Maybe McKelly, do you have that kind of time though? See, that's exactly what I meant. Pokemon Blue. Do you have a stream set up for a Game Boy, or are you just going to play an emulator? Hello. What's going on?
Where is it?
Oh.
I'm a psycho.
Good. Good. I did say hello. Yeah, sure. No problem. That's all good, bro.
So right now I'm working on the last scene. It's kind of a
an aftermath almost scene, like an epilogue, that actually takes place near the end of the whole story arc. I decided yesterday, I don't know if you were here for that, Michele, I decided yesterday that I was going to cut most of the scenes because they were unnecessary to the type of story I was trying to tell. But I did want to have an epilogue scene where I would kind of bring it all full circle. Not that I'm 100% sure what that circle is yet, but yeah. So this one takes place in the middle of the demon summoning ritual. Zodnik's just been possessed, Zodnik being the fawn, who is probably not mentioned actively enough at all. Yeah. What else? Yeah, this is after Hae Perrinor and Personoe have been captured. Yeah. Not sure. Is that helpful? Yes, no? Feel free to ask questions if not. I might have to rethink this scene. I have some distinct ideas for where I, what I want to do with it, but at the same time, I wonder if it's necessary. But, you know, I'll write it anyway, and if I cut it, I cut it. I think it's more necessary than the other stuff I cut, so, you know. Yeah, okay. I don't even know how he's gonna escape. Whatever. Yeah, this is a short story. I started it on stream in episode 3, so almost 2 months ago now. This week I've been drafting all week, making some significant progress. Pretty happy with that. Still probably going to be another few weeks to finish, but you know, we'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes. Really? Because I don't have any books on Amazon. Maybe one day. The writing community on Twitch is growing, apparently. I haven't spent that much time with writers on here, unfortunately. My opinions on self-publishing aside, getting to that point is an achievement in and of itself. But, you know, depends. I don't necessarily dismiss it just because they're self-published. Sure, but you know, it's not everyone. I studied screenwriting in college. I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence. I like prose. I like storytelling and prose. I like the markets that prose has. I like the style of writing in screenplays better. It's easier. It's easier for me. I can't do it, Michele. I can't do it. I thought long and hard about it, and I can't do it. It comes down to two things. One, copyright issues. It gets a little weird, and I publish all my VODs to YouTube, and there's a lot of stuff. And I don't really want people monetizing my work. So there's a lot of weirdness with that. And then two, I get super distracted. So it would have to be where only the stream could hear it. And I don't think that would help. I don't understand why you don't like them. I prefer it. I prefer ones that don't stick to formats. Are you saying because it's difficult to learn off them? Yeah, go ahead. No problem. If you want to listen to music, please go ahead. That's one of the things too, is like, I know that as the streamer, it's my call what music gets played, but I would rather just let you guys listen to whatever you guys want and stuff you like. I think that's sort of true. I think it depends. Usually they'll read the first 5 pages. If you don't impress them in the first 5 pages, then you're done. It depends. It depends on, like, if you're talking about formatting, you can format however you like. You can format within the rules, and that's fine. I don't know. I don't think of it as that big a deal. Well, sure. But I assume that you had a decent log line to begin with. Otherwise, why would you bother submitting?
Damn it.
Step fourth? I don't think so. That's more of a like myth descriptor sort of thing. He stepped forth from the flames, blah. Nah. I think, like, step forth is like a, is something people would say, but it's not something that you would write, if that makes sense. Like, if my character was telling a story, he would say a step forth, but you wouldn't say, like, the narrator, the third person omniscient narrator or whatever wouldn't necessarily say that. That makes sense. I think that makes sense. remember now. Of course, McKelly. I'm always wrong. Two X's. Sorry, I've been having this discussion with Stevie, of course being Stevie Ray Drawn, the awesome Adobe streamer who I will shout out, who is a good friend of mine and is a writer as well as artist, and gives me lots of good advice and asks me to edit her things and all that good stuff. So she was asking me thematically about another project I was working on, and I wanted to send her a message before I forgot what I was thinking. I'll try not to do as much of that for the rest of the stream, but I definitely forget things if I don't write them down right away, so wanted to make sure I got that off there. God, I had that song stuck in my head. Like, it's bad. It's bad, man. It's so bad. Oh, yes. My vibe is showing up today. I'm very excited. Is it weird to write this in all caps? I want his voice to be different. Maybe I should italicize it. That would be better. Who's an enemy of Hades? Do we know? Other than Zeus. Zeus tends to be an enemy of Hades. This is probably almost impossible to read, isn't it? I should bump this up a bit. That's better. Destroys the light. Oh, that's so cool. Gabos, tricks are for kids. Man, I increased it too. I'm sad. Sorry, bro. Hey, question. What's going on, man? I swear, I increased it. Okay. All right, let's make this 21. What were you playing? Oh, Guild Wars, probably. Are you playing the Guild Wars? I assume you're playing Guild Wars. Yeah. Fuck. Skull Kickers is so good. I'm a huge fan of Jim Zub. Jim Zub is awesome. His other comic, which I'll just show briefly here, Wayward, is super cool. I can spell. This Wayward, super cool. It's about Japanese mythology. It's excellent. Though I haven't read nearly as much of that as Skull Kickers. Skull Kickers is just bae. So bae. Yeah. Gym's up. That's not... That's how he credits himself. His name's actually Zubovich. Zubovich? Something like that. No. He's made a lot of Skull Kickers free to promote it. He's very good about stuff like that. And, oh, I don't have the third hardcover. I need to get the third hardcover. Huge fan of Jim Zub. Great guy. I went to the school that he works at, actually. I went there for 2 years. I didn't know of his existence at the time, though, unfortunately. And it's not like something you could just kind of go up to a guy and be like, hey, I'm a big fan at their place of work. Yeah, I hear you, bro. I hear you. I did that for a while when I first got a job. No, I didn't know about him at the time. And, yo, question, I'll help you out there, buddy. Let me do something here. I'm gonna fool around my Nightbot settings for a sec. Snap protection, excess caps, options, regular, submit, symbol, regular, submit, excess, sorry, bro. I will get that fixed. I don't mind having that stuff in place. Like, it prevents any ridiculousness, but... did that not add you? Okay, it did. Excellent. So, add you. I'll add Michele while I'm here. I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to. It was an accident. Really sorry, question. I didn't mean to do that, buddy. I apologize. That super sucks. Hello. Oh, you're back, Michele. I also added you to the regulars, Michele, so you shouldn't get... You should be exempt from... caps and stuff. You're welcome. Yeah, you can caps now. Congratulations. I am good. How are you? Oh yeah, Mikella, I listened to that interview yesterday. It was mind-blowing. It was so good. Yeah, I hear ya. Streaming's been helping with that, for sure. Just my life in general. I've been making a lot of life changes. Yeah, the Tolkien one. In order to be more productive. No, totally, the Tolkien one. So good. Posted a link in a couple Discords yesterday, or did I send it to you? Either way, just let me know if you can't find it, and I'll pass it along. I really enjoyed it. Thank you.
There we go.
Alright, it's been about an hour. I'm going to take a 5 minute break, get up, stretch my legs. I suggest you all do the same. Yeah, it's good to stretch. Not remain seated for too long. We're making good progress today. 200 words in the first hour. I'm still unsure of whether or not this scene matters, but I have a few more ideas and I'm going to get them down, and after that, I'll decide better whether or not it'll be included in the next draft. But, you know, we'll see how it goes. There you go. I apologize, question. I tried to fix it and I made it worse. Oh well. I added you to the regulars list, so you should be exempt from that now. Hopefully. Anyway, 5 minute break. I'll see y'all in a bit. Okay, I'm back. Thank you. this is too on point, but the sentiment is true, so I'm going to add it anyway. I'll probably rewrite it into something a little more subtle later. Many questions in this section. One second, I gotta go into the door. write that. Guess what just showed up? I look like I'm dropping frames. getting close to the end of this scene. Hey, Johnny, what's going on? Just got here, like I answered the door 10 minutes ago, maybe. Getting some drop frames. No problem, Johnny. No problem. They're okay, I'm writing fairly well. I'm unsure of whether or not this scene is necessary. or if I want to do something shorter or different with it. But I won't know that until a later draft, I think. I think there's enough here to kind of bring the characters full circle. Like, change it from where he was in the inciting incident to sort of the end of the story. But yeah, I'm not sure if I want to do it in this exact way later on. But, you know, that's part of the editing process, right? Please, you're the way better streamer than me. I definitely have to be the Kohai. Yeah. Just kind of thinking through it, you know? Is my signal really messed up? Am I dropping a lot of frames? I mean, I suppose 2.6% is not a ton of frames, but still. Okay. So cliche. Whatever. It's good. It's good enough. Okay, I think that scene's at least somewhat done. I want to compile this real quick. I kind of want to see what the entirety of it looks like. Why is Adobe not scale their menus? It's so big. Yeah, it's because I have two different monitors at two different resolutions, and it looks perfect on my big monitor, but on my small monitor, I think basically what's happened is it's not changed. It's the same scale. It doesn't rescale for the secondary monitor. So yeah.
I like that paragraph a lot.
Interesting.
Is it compiling it wrong? It is too. Oh, it's this one. No wonder I can't read it. So much more sense. Yeah, that's definitely easier to read. I hate Courier New. I love Courier Prime. It's hard to debate that they're the most readable font once you get used to them. Thank you. Screenplays have to be formatted in Courier. It's been an industry standard for a long time, and a lot of readers will not even look at your script if it's not in Courier. Yeah, a little bit. I'm not thinking about this story as much as I'm thinking about some of my other projects. There's passion. I'm just kind of stuck up here rather than out here. Because I'm trying to stick to my guns, Johnny. I'm trying to stick to my guns. 3 hours of writing, streaming, you know?
Let me work for another 40 minutes, and then at the end of the stream, I'll stop it real quick and start it again, and I'll do like half hour. I'll start unpacking it. But yeah, I wanna actually get some of this done. Then I can reward myself. Especially because I'm sitting at 462 words right now, so I think I can afford to miss that half hour. I need a party snake emote. That's what I need. It'll definitely translate better than the keyboard. A lot of stuff doesn't have mainstream VR support yet. Pretty sure Minecraft does, but I'm not sure about that. I definitely need a party snake. That has to happen.
Yeah, I definitely want to play the lab more. I tried that out at Sam's house. It's really cool. I want to try Tilt Brush. Looks really cool. There's a few other things. There's a couple of games I have that don't necessarily have VR support, but I've heard would be cool VR experiences either way. So, you know, hard to say. I'd have to double check to see if it's actually set up properly. That's not true. Super lame. It's lame. I think it's lame. This guy just has so many questions. I don't like this transition, but I don't have another idea at the moment. No, I was talking to Stevie. Yeah, I was talking to McKelly. It was Sam Peterson, Stevie, and he couldn't remember the third person. But I figured, because I knew both Sam Peterson and Stevie, who both love you, were streaming last night, that that's who you were talking about. You know, 15 viewers is not, it's nothing to sniff at. Hmm.
Why? Why do you feel bad? You shouldn't feel bad. You should be very happy. I'm proud of you. Much as I can do for now. It's all good. I realize that writing on Twitch is a much smaller niche than art. And while I think that it can be attractive to artists, it's not necessarily something that they're interested in spending time watching when they could be watching people who are doing art and learning something specifically to their passion. And I also understand that visually speaking, writing is not as interesting. That being said, I mean, I'm experiencing steady growth. I have no issues with the way that I've been progressing. If I streamed more often, I think I would get, I would grow faster, but I can't. My work schedule doesn't allow it. So, weird. I'm sad I couldn't be there, but that wasn't my fault either. It's not much I could have done about that. And I realized after talking with Stevie this week and a few other things that, you know, I stream for fun. I stream because it pushes me. I get to have cool conversations. I get to meet new people. I'm not streaming to make money. I'm not streaming to, like, be the next Day 9 or something like that. I'm not really planning on making streaming how I make my living. So that's okay. It's okay to have a smaller community and all that. As long as the conversations are there, as long as the learning is there. And I'm not talking just about people learning from me, but also me learning from other people. You know what I mean? Yeah, and I'm trying to put myself out there more. I'm trying to put my writing out there more, get more eyes on it, get more opinions, see what things I can improve. Right? So, doing what I can. I have seen that. It looks really cool. Is it 60? I heard it was 30, but 60 could make sense. I just didn't see the thing. I'd like to see the list of what games come preloaded with it if they haven't released it yet. Uh,
It seems like a solid list, but it has stuff I don't care that much about, but it's missing a few that I think should be there. What the hell? Oh, yeah, no. No, no links, sorry. Maybe. I'll think about that too. Yeah, I found it. That being said, for $60. It's hard to go wrong. Some NES games cost more than that. There's a real nostalgia factor. I would have liked to have seen some more of the classic Final Fantasies. But maybe that was the only one released on NES. I could be wrong. Johnny, you can play anything with an emulator. That doesn't mean it's good. Or that you should. Yeah, it's not as fun playing those games without a controller. And like, not just any controller, but like the NES controller sort of thing. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Final Fantasy II was never released on NES. I don't think. Or maybe it was. I don't know. Oh, it was. It was. Only in Japan, though. They're saying that it's not, you're not going to be able to add anything to it. The most liquid. Just trying to add as much detail as I can. Get that last little bit in. No, totally not. I just seeing if I can spot area that could use more. Not really trying to force it. think that's it. I also think I need to cut today a little bit early.
I got things happening, and I need to work on another project. But I've been super happy with my progress so far this week. It's going really, really well. I wrote 5,000 words in, or sorry, 3,000 words in 6 days or 5 days. That's pretty good for me. On one story anyway. Definitely excited about that. Tomorrow, and it looks like I will be streaming tomorrow. Tomorrow, what I'm going to do is I will print this tonight, and I'll set up the Gorilla Cam so that we can do editing, some basic editing stuff tomorrow. And I'll talk about that a little bit more in detail tomorrow, I think. It's 2:25, so I'll be on for another 5 minutes or so. If you have any questions for me, let me know. I prefer doing my editing by hand. I know Stevie has said the same. It's easier. It's easier to read it on paper. I know digital books are a thing, and I love reading digitally. Like, I love reading ebooks digitally and all that stuff. But when you're editing, it needs to be on paper. You notice things differently. It's a whole different experience. It's easier to write comments. It's easier to do certain things. So I think that would be cool to do that. And I have to talk to Sam, but I'm going to be going to my regular episode time on Sunday. So 7 p.m. Eastern. That episode should be the interview episode. I'm going to talk to Sam about that and get that all sorted out. I'm going to bring on Sam, and we're going to talk about writing and talk about process and talk about different things. I'm going to leave it mostly up to him as a moderator, what he wants to talk about. We'll see how it goes. While that's happening, because of the editing tomorrow, while that's happening, I'll probably just be typing in like sort of some of the changes and stuff like that. Give you something to look at while we're doing it. It's okay to do digitally. It depends what you're doing it in. There are certain tools that make it really easy to collaborate. Like doing digital editing on like Google Docs is not too bad, but it's easier to do by hand. The problem is if you do it by hand, then you have to either scan stuff or type it all back in, and that sucks. It's not fun. Just things I'm thinking about. Cool. I'm super happy with this. When I get off here, I'm going to be uploading. All the VODs, and I'll upload a copy of the first draft. Along with that on the website. So if you want to check that out, look it over, let me know what you think. Please feel free. I'll be looking it over myself tomorrow. So I think that's it for me. Yeah, I'm not gonna unpack my stuff on stream. I feel too weird about it. But yeah. So other than that, I think that's it for me today. I've accomplished my 500 words. I got that scene written. I added as much detail as I could. I think we're on to the next step. Super happy with the way that this is progressing. Very, very happy. All right. Cool. So, 229. I will see you all later. Bye.